Once again, we're in our units and options.dwg file, and it's in the same state as it was at the end of the last video. I've left it zoomed to the extent in the model tab, as you can see bottom left there. Now, what we're going to have a look at is another way of setting settings in your AutoCAD. Now, we've touched on units already in the previous video. You can also utilize the options dialog box. Now, the options dialog box has many, many settings in there, many of which you will never touch or change, but you just need to know where it is in order to change those settings. Now, you can jump up here to the application menu, click on the flyout and open it up, and there's a button at the bottom of the application menu that you click on. It says options. Click on it. It opens the options dialog box. That's one way of doing it. I could also just type the word options if I wanted to. On my dynamic input, you can see there's the options option, if you'll pardon the pun, on the suggestion menu. So I could do that and just press enter, and that'll bring up the options dialog box. Now, the way that I like to do it, though, I'll just cancel it, is if you haven't got a command running, just a quick right click, options at the bottom of the shortcut menu, and that'll bring up the options dialog box. Now, as I said, there's many, many options, commands, settings, and everything in here that you can change, update, and move around. Now, what I'm going to do is just show you a couple of things that are always useful. So if I go to files here on the tab at the top, you can see these are all the locations of all of the different files that AutoCAD uses to function in your Windows operating system. One of them that I always recommend that you change is the automatic save file location. Now, I haven't changed it. It just goes to my temp folder on my C drive. But what happens if your machine breaks down? You've got no way of getting back to that last automatic save in a different AutoCAD, perhaps on a different workstation, perhaps on a laptop. You've left a file at home and it's somewhere else in a cloud server. You can't get access to that temporary file. So what you do is you just click here, go to browse and change the location and set it in your options. Always change that from the temp folder on your C drive. I'm not a good example because I haven't, obviously, but I'm just using my training machine that I use to record all my videos. So I wouldn't worry about it too much in my particular case. But always change your automatic save file location in the files tab. Now, display. You can change things in your display if you wish. Now, again, lots and lots of different settings here. You can change your crosshair size. And one of the ones that I often show people is this here, colors. So at the moment, you can see we've got a nice dark background in the drawing area. So what I can do here, 2D model space is where I am, uniform background. Let's change that to say white. And when I apply and close that, can you see it goes white? And we've still got the options dialog box open because I clicked on apply and close. Now, what we've got here is a really bright white that I find really difficult to look at because I'm so used to working with that dark setting. Now, you'll notice the dark color theme is still set to dark up here on the ribbon, but not in the drawing area. So I go back to colors, 2D model space, uniform background. I restore that current element. You'll also need to make sure that your crosshairs are restored and your viewport control is restored. So there's your viewport control there, and obviously your crosshairs are what move around, your cursor on the screen. When you apply and close that, you can see there's your view control there. And if I close this by clicking on OK, my crosshairs are white again as well. Otherwise, they'll be black because they've gone black because you changed the background to white earlier. Let's just right click and jump back into options again. I just want to show you one more thing in the open and save tab. You'll notice here all my drawings save back to a 2013 DWG file. Like I said in the introduction, all of the exercise files are saved back to this 2013 format. You'll notice you can go up to a 2018 DWG. But the problem you've got there is you can then only open that DWG file with AutoCAD 2018 and above. If I save back to 2013, that means everybody with AutoCAD 2013 and upwards can open my DWG files. Always worth remembering that one. And if you do save back to a much older version of AutoCAD, Make sure that these two are ticked as well. Maintain visual fidelity for annotative objects and maintain your drawing size compatibility for large files as well. Just make sure that they're ticked as well if you're going back to older versions. Now, we've got plot and publish. You can set your printer that you're going to print to. System, we've got things like graphics performance. So we can open up the graphic performance dialog box and check what our settings are on our graphics card. User preferences, I can change settings in here. Now, we mentioned units as well. Here is the insertion scale setting. Do you remember when we set our units, we said that we wanted things to come in millimeters? Well, what it's done is it's set those there to millimeters, okay? Now, in one of the videos in this particular chapter, I'll show you how to change this and bring imperial units into a metric millimeters drawing. And that's really clever because what I can do is objects that are using those imperial units can come in, but they will be metric already. And AutoCAD will scale those up for you. You can do it with blocks, you can do it with drawings, and so on and so forth. And I'll show you how to do that. Drafting, you can change your drafting settings. So things like your aperture size on your crosshair can be changed. 3D modeling, I'm not going to go into that because we're not 3D modeling, but again, settings in your options. Selection, you can change your grip size, your pick box size, and so on. And you can also have different AutoCAD profiles as well. So you'll notice there we've got an unnamed profile in place, and obviously that's what we're using at the moment. So that's all your different options available to you when you're setting up your AutoCAD. I'll just basically cancel that now and come out of it so that I don't make any dramatic changes to my AutoCAD setup.